Now I will be reacting to the top 10 movie reacting. I guess.
Let's see who's really out there. Welcome to WatchMojo.com.
Mike Myers, Ghostface.
Top 10 horror.
The guy.
From
Max.
We're taking a look at the pivotal moments in horror movies where a villain or a threatening character has his or her identity exposed by means of unmasking. Whether or not it's the villain, as unmasking is generally a big finale or at least a surprise, a spoiler alert is now in effect.
Oh, told you.
Number 10, Polite Leader, The Purge.
I know this one.
This world, for one night of the year, every crime is legal. And on the night of the Purge, it seems there are a lot more people out there who feel inclined to kill rather than just leave the place on the property. For the Sandin family,
someone told me that they're actually going to try that. But, dude, I'm just going to stay in our basement all night. Not basement, really. Yeah, our parents call it the basement, because it's most secure if a tree falls. Something. It's like our roof, and then my parents' bedroom, and then it'd be going through that. No, I didn't even watch. Let me pause that. Yeah, so like, we were just probably sitting there with my dad's, like, axes, my dad's machetes. Yeah. But I'm gonna have to redo this. Sorry for the crappy, annoying voices. Right there. My dumb brother. Well, he's not dumb, he's watching his dumb people.
No, they are! I like them! But you like Dan TDM, I don't.
You like Dan TDM.
No, I don't.
Like, I don't love him. He's, like, he's good. I'm not obsessed like he is with popular memos. Well, I thought you always wanted to see this asking. Like, I've heard of this movie in it. I know it's like a pumpkin base, kind of.
Number 7, Tomás Simón, The Orphanage, a.k.a. El Orfanato.
Simón?
After Laura buys and moves back to the orphanage where she grew up.
The orphanage is Spanish?
Makes friends with a boy named Tomás, who may or may not be real. But soon after, Simón goes missing. What's weird is Laura herself begins to see the imaginary friend who hides his face with a mask. That's why she believes it's her missing boy. Or the ghost of a social worker's son who drowned. Her search finally leads her to a secret basement where she finds a body, which she originally thinks, or just hopes, belongs to Tomás. But sadly, when she removes the mask, she sees it's actually her son. It's a heartbreaking moment in an otherwise chilling film.
Why don't we get to see the feet?
Number 6, Lamb Mask.
I feel like this movie so much. Finally, I want to see.
But from murder to the next, and it's a whole new nightmare.
Why don't I just search the other? I'm so dumb.
When killers begin to pick off and beat down one by one, it seems there's no stopping them. But when their interest is like that, it becomes clear that the
wolf
wasn't so random after all. With each killer hiding behind a different animal mask, it's finally revealed the man with the lamb mask is a hired assassin, and the younger Davison brother is responsible for the whole plot. Excuse me?
Say that like it's my fault.
Number 5, Dr. Hannibal Lecter, The Silence of the Lambs.
I was good to watch this, but I wanted to see it long term more.
It
sounds
for
Lambston, but this is dumb. Yeah, it's Hannibal Lecter.
Number 4,
already know them. That, I already know what he looks like. I was Michael Myers for Halloween. Uncle? This looks like a good, I'm asking. See this on mask.
Turns out it isn't one pair of stockings in Prescott and the other team in the high school, but two. The joke is that it works. Always a boyfriend, but it never is. Well, in this self-aware scarefest, it actually is. The catch is, he's been working alongside his best friend under the guise of Ghostface. Together, they even fake Billy's death in a great twist that helps set the standard for modern horror. Frequently imitated, but never duplicated. This is the unmasking of the decade.
What's the matter, Sydney? You look like you've seen a ghost.
Number one, Jason Voorhees, Friday the 13th, Part 3. One of the most famous masks in the cinematic horror canon belongs to one Jason Voorhees. However, it wasn't until the third installment of the Friday the 13th franchise that this mask was introduced. Before that, he just used a cloth sack to hide his features. Following the events of Part 2, Jason is back to pull off Chris Higgins.
Is he embryed or something? We'll see you guys. Yeah.